Now, antibiotic resistance is one of the biggest threats to global health, to food security, and even to the longevity of the whole human race. It can affect everybody in every country of any age. Welcome back to How to Medicate, and today we will cover antibiotic resistance. We will cover all the ins and outs, and if you want to learn more on how to use a certain antibiotic, then check out my playlist in the description. For those of you I'm meeting for the first time, my name is Raoul. I'm a medical doctor from the Netherlands. I'm making weekly medical videos to educate myself as well as you, my viewer, because I believe that medically educated people make healthier decisions, and that's what this channel is all about. This video also comes with a quick disclaimer. It's meant purely informative. This is not medical advice, and if you're looking for medical advice, always contact your own doctor. Now let's get started. Now, first of all, antibiotics are used to treat or prevent infections with microorganisms, most often bacteria. There are many different types of antibiotics, each working in a different way and effective in a different type of bacteria. And if you're interested, I could make a video on all these different types of antibiotics. Just let me know in the comment section. Now, most commonly, these antibiotics destroy the cell wall of a bacteria, they prevent it from replicating, or they destroy its energy supply. All are very effective. But bacteria can strike back. They're constantly replicating, which can cause natural mutations that make them resistant to a certain antibiotic. Misuse of antibiotics in humans or in animals can also rapidly accelerate this process. Now picture this. Normally, an antibiotic can cling to the cell wall of a bacteria and starts to break it down. But now, because this bacteria mutated, its cell wall changed, and the antibiotic cannot cling to the cell wall anymore. The outcome, the bacteria became resistant to this antibiotic and it's ineffective anymore. The only thing we can do now is hope that another antibiotic still is effective against this bacteria, otherwise we have no treatment anymore. It's important here to note that the bacteria itself became immune to the antibiotic and not we as humans. This is a constant struggle in the medical world where we are fighting these bacteria with our limited supply of antibiotics, while they become increasingly more mutated and more immune. In recent years, only very few new antibiotics have been developed. This is because there was no need for new antibiotics. Our current antibiotics were so effective at treating all the bacteria, so pharmaceutical companies didn't spend all the time and resources developing new ones. But today, it's quite a different story. There are more and more superinfections resistant to one or more antibiotics we currently have. And our arsenal to fight them with, or antibiotics, it's aging. Therefore, these bacteria are currently unchallenged. We have super resistant strains of pneumonia, tuberculosis, gonorrhea, and salmonellosis. Worldwide, it's estimated that we have about 700,000 deaths each year due to drug-resistant infections. And this may rise to as many as 10 million in the year 2050. The answer seems simple. We need new and effective antibiotics. And the medical world realizes this as well. More and more research is done to find new and effective antibiotics. But the World Health Organization thinks none of the current trials will lead to an antibiotic which will be effective against the most dangerous forms of antibiotic-resistant bacteria. If this is true, it will take many more years before we will have an effective antibiotic. This is a global problem, maybe even a bigger one than the current coronavirus pandemic, and it will require the efforts of all nations involved to solve it. The impact of antibiotic resistance is enormous. It will lead to increased medical costs, prolonged hospital stays, and increased mortality. It's putting the achievements of modern medicine at risk. Organ transplant, chemotherapy, and surgery will be much more dangerous without effective antibiotics. And worse yet, without urgent action, we are heading for a post-antibiotic era. An era in which minor injuries and wounds can once more kill again. And it almost sounds like I'm making it up here, but I'm not. I used this information directly from the World Health Organization. And you can find the article I used in the description. Now let's end off this video positively, because there is a solution. The world needs to change its way it uses and prescribes antibiotics. Otherwise, even new antibiotics can't help us, because we keep allowing bacteria to become resistant. We need to prevent misuse and overuse of antibiotics, as well as increase our infection and prevention control. And here is what you can do. Only use antibiotics when prescribed by your physician. Never demand antibiotics if your physician says you don't need them. Never share or use leftover antibiotics. And try to prevent infections by regularly washing your hands, preparing food hygienically, avoid close contact with sick people, practice safer sex, and keep your vaccinations up to date. And of course, leave a like for the YouTube algorithm. Now, I hope I didn't scare you too much with this video, but I found it necessary to spread more awareness on antibiotic resistance. Because I believe that medically educated people make healthier decisions, and this can keep you and your loved ones safe. Also, feel free to share this video with everybody you know, which will spread even more awareness and will also hopefully keep them safe. Lastly, if you never want to miss a video again, then consider subscribing. I make awesome medical content each and every week, and it will also help me to reach my 3K subscriber milestone. Thank you for watching, and as always, I will see you next week. Bye bye.